This tutorial will show you how to set up a parametric modulation analysis in AFNI. A review of parametric modulation, as well as the data set we will be analyzing, can be found in the video link down below. We will first create timing files that contain onsets for the gamble, the parametric value for the potential gain, and the parametric value for the potential loss for each run. You can download a script to convert the timings into a format that AFNI understands by going to this repository. Clicking on Make GambleTimings.sh, and then clicking on the Raw button, right-clicking anywhere, Save As, and then saving it into the gambles directory. Once it has been downloaded, navigate to that directory with the terminal and run the script by typing bash make gambletimings.sh. Within each func directory, you should now see a file called gamble_timings.1d, which looks like the following if we use the cat command. This has three columns. The first number is the onset of the gamble. The asterisk indicates that the numbers coming after it are the modulators, separated by a comma. We will use this in the model for each subject. Similar to the scripting part of the AFNI tutorial, we will create a script that can be used in a for loop to analyze all of our subjects. Instead of using the uber-subject-py GUI, however, we will use the command afni-proc-py. The script can be downloaded here. Run afni-proc. Again, click on Raw, right-click and choose Save As, and download it to the gambles directory. If we open the file, this is what is inside. The first line, after the shebang, means to use the first argument as the subject variable. Then we have the blocks like T-shift, align, tally rack, and so on, which indicate the standard preprocessing steps of slice timing correction, realignment, etc. The major difference from analyzing a non-parametric modulation dataset is using AM2, which stands for amplitude modulation. This will orthogonalize the modulators with respect to the mean regressor, but not with respect to each other. For more details on why this is important, see the link to the Mumford et al. Paper down below. Now that we have the template preprocessing script, we can use it in a for loop to analyze all the subjects. Type the following, start running the for loop, and we will come back when it finishes in a couple of hours. When the script finishes, you should see one results directory per subject. If we navigate into one of the output directories, such as sub01 results, and open AFNI, we can load the warped anatomical image as an underlay and the stats sub01 image as an overlay. In the Define Overlay window, there are multiple options in the Olay and Threshold drop-down menus. The first one, Gamble 0 COEF, is the beta weight for the mean regressor of Gamble, while Gamble 1 COEF corresponds to the parametric modulator of gain, and Gamble 2 COEF corresponds to the parametric modulators of loss. These are subrics 3 and 5. We will use these last two regressors as inputs into our group level analysis. You can download the group analysis script here in the repository, under Run Group Level Analysis, Gain PM, and also the Loss PM. We're going to download and save each of those into the gamble directory. Once we've saved it to the directory, from the terminal, type tcsh rungroupanalysis_gainpm.sh. This will create a group level output directory, test results gain PM, which you can load in AFNI. You can overlay the results on a template brain, and then threshold the results at whatever level you want. At a relatively liberal, voxel-wise, uncorrected threshold of p equals 0.01, you can see that the gain modulators load significantly on the caudate nucleus. If we do the same analysis for the loss modulators, again, by typing TCSH, run group analysis, loss PM, we'll do the same setup, using the AFNI GUI to switch between the datasets. Compare these results to the Tom et al. Paper. Do the results look similar? We could strengthen our results by changing the preprocessing or the GLM, for example, by increasing the smoothing kernel or by using REML model estimation. This is left as an exercise for you to do on your own.